Good morning, guys, and welcome back to my channel. And today we'll be painting a butterfly. And let me tell you the colors that we'll be using for today's painting. Okay, we have lemon yellow, permanent yellow deep, burnt sienna, permanent orange, black, permanent light green, and raw umber. And of course, titanium white. So let's proceed now. That was a 30-second intro. I really don't make a lot of long intros, guys. Okay, so let me first do the background. I'm gonna get my light green, and then lemon yellow, tiny bit of white here. Okay, I'm gonna get my permanent light green mixed with tiny bit of raw umber here. Okay, maybe more raw umber just to make it more dark. The background is more of a suggestion of a garden, but we're not gonna paint the garden, just the suggestion. So like green background like that. Okay, we're gonna go back to light green, so green and yellow plus white. Okay, like that, and go here. That. Then let's go back to raw umber plus green and here. And I'm gonna make some light green again and then yellow. Okay, like that. And we can go back to it later. Actually, we can simply go there now. I'm gonna get my green and yellow here. Okay, and then dark green. Now earlier it was raining quite hard, but now it's like the sun is shining. Alright, like that. Then get your green and yellow plus white. Just blend. Okay. Okay. Last, just do some green. Here. All right. Okay. Wash your brush out. I'm gonna get my burnt sienna, raw umber, a lot of white, and then tiny bit of black. Oh, that's a lot of black. I'm gonna add more white and then burnt sienna, like this color, and tiny bit of yellow, like this. Okay, more yellow and then more white. I'm gonna do the wood same mixture here. Like that. Okay, thank you. Sorry, guys. The management just checked my temperature. Because as I already told you, I'm still in quarantine. Like that. This is the a piece of wood where the butterfly is or where the butterfly is like having some rest. Okay, like that. Okay, we're just gonna go back to it later for the highlights. For now, the underpainting will be like that. Okay, wash your brush out. Okay, wash your brush out. You know, it's quite sunny. Earlier, it was like raining so hard. I'm gonna get my permanent orange with tiny bit of brown. And tiny bit of permanent yellow deep. Okay, here. I'm just gonna dab in. Here. And here I'm gonna add a tiny bit of yellow. Okay, and then orange again. Okay, I might get some red, by the way. So I'm gonna get my red. Okay, I'm gonna get my red. Okay, like that. Okay, and I'm just gonna dab in some red while the orange mixture is still wet. Here, I'm gonna add burnt sienna to the red. Okay, wipe it down. Of course, fingers. And then I'm gonna add black to the red mixture. And then I'm just gonna dab in. I'm gonna use my black mixture. And apply it here. Okay, like that. Okay, and then I'm gonna use the black mixture or the dark mixture here. Okay. I can use more pointy brush. So I'm gonna get my black and mix it with a tiny bit of red and orange so that it's not absolutely black. Then we're going to make the markings. Okay, like that. Okay, same black mixture. I'm just making some black spots. Okay, like that. Okay, then more black. Are we still good? Okay. Okay. Like that. Then I'm gonna water down a black. Just make some applications here and there. Alright, so I'm gonna use the black mixture and mix it with yellow. So that I'll make something like this color, like muted yellow. Okay, I'm gonna water it down. Gonna get the black. Okay, I'm gonna get my brown and then apply it here like that. I'm gonna get my brown and white here. Now it's sunny outside. Okay, I'm gonna get my black. Like that. Okay. And then I'm gonna make some black line here. I'm gonna use, okay, I might need some phthalo blue. Okay, I'm gonna use my phthalo blue. And then I'm gonna add phthalo blue to the black mixture. So add phthalo blue and white. And then black, like that. Okay, like that. And then I'm gonna just water it down just to do the shadow. Like that. Okay, and then I'm gonna add some white to it to make it lighter here. Okay, then here. Okay, I'm gonna add white to the pillow. Okay, I'm gonna get my dark grays again with blue here. Let's just go back. Okay, let's see. Okay. Okay, like that. Okay, I'm gonna fill in the small gaps that I had. Okay. For now, that is going to be the shadow, and then we're going to add the details later. Now let's get our burnt sienna and then white and then tiny bit of black and yellow, like this color, and then white, tiny bit of black. Okay, like this. Okay. Okay, let's try to apply it, okay? More white. Okay, you don't have to be super neat in doing the wood, because it has a lot of unevenness. Okay. Like that. Here. So keep adding brownie mixture, yellow mixture, and white to the wood just to create the natural effect. I'm gonna get some raw umber. Here, down here. Okay, raw umber plus white. Umber. Like that. Okay, like that. Okay, raw umber just to create some patterns, just like those of a typical piece of wood. Oops. Okay, like that. Okay, I'm gonna let it dry. I'm gonna wash my brush out. And I'm gonna darken some areas on the shadow. I'm gonna get my black. back, and then some lines, because the shadow should not absolutely or totally cover the wooden pattern, because shadow is quite lighter than black. Okay. All right, so I'm gonna use my black and mix it with orange. All right, like that. And then I'm gonna wash my brush out. I'm gonna get my permanent yellow deep and then make some lighter areas. That's quite dirty. Okay, I'm gonna use my more yellow. Like that. Okay, I'm gonna get my white and yellow. Okay, just to make some highlights. Here, I'm just gonna make some random white markings. Okay, wash your brush out. Okay, I'm gonna get my pure white. I'm gonna get my pure white and just apply it here to do some highlights. I told you guys, every time I'm painting, that sounds, you know, I mean, that sound always like have to be noisy. Okay. Here. kind of like that. And then some areas will be light. To suggest some light. So I'm using dry brushing, or I'm doing dry brushing for the wood to create that wooden effect. Like that. Okay, nice. Right? That. Okay. Okay. We're not yet done with the butterfly. So I'm gonna get my brown black mixture. So burnt sienna and black. Okay, burnt sienna and black. And make sure you can do a straight line. Okay, oh, wait, I made a mistake. Painting is like life. We make mistakes. I know, that's so corny and cheesy. Okay. Okay, like this. And then just make small, like antenna. Okay, like that. And then I'm gonna get my white. I'm gonna mix it with a tiny bit of white just to make it more light. And then I'm gonna make some like the leg. That. Okay, and then I'm gonna make my dark here again, my black plus blue mixture. Okay, I'm just gonna make some shadow for the antenna. Like that. Also here, but very, very subtle. Like that. Just to suggest it. Like that. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna get my black. I'm gonna get my pure black this time, and I'm just gonna make some lines. As I told you, the wooden marks should still be visible even under the shadow, because the shadow is a mere play of light. It does not paint the surface. Just be like natural. Your line should not be straight, but I mean may or may not be straight, but the appearance of non-straight lines just makes your painting more natural. That's it. Okay, wash your brush out. And then I'm gonna get my orange mixed with red and black, and I'm just gonna go back to my butterfly. I think I need more red. I need more red. And I'm not scrubbing to give it more natural effect. Okay, and then you can wash your brush out. Okay, I'm gonna get my orange and yellow. And I'm just gonna make some of this extension of the wing. Oops. Okay, and then red. Oh, there's black in there. There's a lot of black that should not be there. I'm gonna delete that one. Okay, get your black this time. Then I'm making some like veins like that. Yeah, like this. Dark. Okay. Like that?
Mm-hmm.
That's nice. So I'm gonna use my black, same mixture. Here. And then I'm gonna get my black. Just to make the wood more natural. Okay, I'm gonna get my black just to make some more detailing on the wing. Just dots. Like that. Here. Okay, and then wash your brush out. I'm gonna get my white. My white and just trying to go back to our highlights. Okay, and then I'm gonna make some highlights here like this. Like that. Okay, and then here I'm gonna glaze something because it's not absolutely dark. Paint's still wet. And then here as well, make some natural. Just to define our wood. Okay. We're almost done. I'm gonna get some gray. So apply it quite randomly because the more random you do this, the more natural it looks, or it's gonna look. So I'm just, okay. I'm gonna use my, I'm gonna use my white, pure white, but watered down white. And then I'm just gonna spread it like that. Fix that. Okay, I'm gonna get my pure black. Like that. Okay, wash your brush up. And I'm gonna get my yellow and white. Apply it there. I'm gonna get my permanent yellow. Permanent yellow plus white. Like that. I'm gonna get my orange and brown. Apply it like this. Okay. How is it? Looks nice. So I'm gonna get my permanent yellow deep again. Okay, I'm sorry. Get some white. So some whites around the shadow. Okay, here as well. Just gonna fill this in right. And here.
Okay, make this a little more brown. Now it's quite sunny. I like it. Okay. Get your black. Like that. Okay.
Right, so where should I sign it?
Okay, wait. I'm gonna add some tiny bit of like greeny color. Like green color. There's some sort of greenness. Again, I'm just doing this to make it look more natural. Like that.
I'm gonna wash my brush out and probably I'm gonna glaze it with white because I feel like, yeah,
it needs glazing. So that no hard lines will appear. Okay, like that. Okay, I'm gonna get some white. And then just highlight again the wing. Okay, and then we're good. I have to sign it now. I'm gonna use my black for a signature. Probably here, right? Okay. Yes, we're done.
We're good. We're good.
Okay, wait.
I'm gonna slightly glaze the upper part with
with some black. I know it's crazy, but I feel like the background should not what they call this, overpower the subject. So I'm just using a rag. Okay.
Oh, that's a lot.
So that's just what I want. The background should not be brighter than the subject. Like that.
Okay, that's good. Perfect. Okay.
So I'm gonna get some pure white. Pure white is for the last step. And I'm gonna dry brush and apply it really randomly on the wood. Random, guys. Okay. Really random. Okay, and then make some dots. Like that. Okay, so we're done, guys. We're done, guys. Yay, this was quite fast. And yeah. So I hope you enjoyed this one. I enjoyed this one. And I hope you tag me on your paintings. See you on my next video, guys. See you guys. See you.